your skin, that shit is popping, girl. Body on tan, damn, you got it, girl. You gotta boss up, getting them checks, living your best, racks up. Oh, keep walking with confidence.
Hey, it is Lexus Exodus, leader of the Black Woman Exodus. How are y'all doing? And like always, if you enjoy this content, please like and subscribe, please share, please comment in the comment section. Let me know that you're listening. Go check out my Patreon community where you can get access to bonus episodes and exclusive content and also a private community of like-minded divested women. It is linked below. Please also follow me on social media platforms. You can check me out everywhere on all platforms at Lexus Exodus. I also have a backup channel just in case something happens to this one. It is called LexEx. That's L-E-X-E-X. You can find all of this information in the description below.
Let's talk about throwbacks tonight. And I have to give my homegirl and the patron Ask Spice and my private group credit for this phrase. She shared this because we talked about this Erica Mena situation this past weekend. If you haven't already, I encourage you to join the private group where we have very riveting, very thought-provoking conversations. But anyway, Ask Spice uses this term to describe a non-Black woman who is dejected and rejected in her own community. Hence the phrase throwback. She's literally a throwaway and thrown back and discarded. So since she is so desperate for validation, she seeks this in the Black community because she can't get it within her own community. So she goes to Blackistan, where even the most basic barnyard Beckys and mediocre Marias are pedestalized because we know the Black community is white worshiping. So most Black women could care less about throwbacks. We don't give a F about what they do. In fact, most Black women embrace and allow these non-Black women to emulate them and to ingratiate themselves into their culture. The problem is most are like Erica Mena, who we will discuss in detail later, but they'll mimic Black women's style. They'll copy our aesthetics and will copy the stereotypical phenotype of a Black woman, the hair, the nails, the lashes, the Black scent, in order to establish these massive platforms within the Black community. But then we'll secretly harbor this disdain, hatred, and superiority complex towards Black women. Okay? So now that we know what a throwback is, let's get into some examples. I want to first talk about this Bekisha throwback with dreads that illustrates the epitome of this.
Of course, it's always the Black women with weaves who want to hate on my beautiful, free-form, curly dreadlocks. It's like, no. Bye, Shaquandra.
She said bye, Shaquandra. No, bye, Bekisha. Bye, Metheny. Bye, you Cave Karen. Bye, you Snow Roach. Looking absolutely ridiculous. You the type of white bitch who thinks since you went for a swim in the lake, you don't got a shower. That counts as bathing. If I shampoo my hair, I don't need to wash my legs because the soapy water just run down the rest of my body. Child, looking like you smell like patchouli, weed, and ass. If you don't get your homely plain Jane, musty, dusty, crusty, overbite, having at the F out of here. Talking about Black women are jealous because you ain't combed those matted, ratty, struggled tresses you passing off as dreads. Child, I can't. Looking like what the cat drug in and what the damn dog threw up. Ain't nobody playing with your broken promises that. Your damn lisp having at. This is a throwback, y'all. This is what me and Ask Spice are referring to when we reference throwbacks. This woman was dejected and rejected by her own community. So she went to the Black community and decided to emulate Black women's hairstyles and now is trying to sport dreads. Now she's lashing out at the very same women she wants to be like, baiting us into these arguments we didn't ask to be in. Talking about bye, Bonquisha, or whatever the hell she said. Girl, bye. Bye, Becky. Attempting to gain clout off of us. And in response to this, I saw a lot of Black women triggered in the comments. I would say, Black women, make your outrage and engagement expensive. Let this throwback bottom feeder have it. Let her continue to have this conversation, this unsolicited conversation, this argument that she's having with herself alone. So here's another throwback expressing these same sentiments.
Raising my hair. No, because I'm not Black. What the fuck does being Black have to do with me doing braids? What, like, someone give me a valid reason. What the fuck does me being Black have anything to do with me doing a hairstyle on my hair? It's the same as a Black girl going to a hair salon and getting her hair blown out. It's literally the same. Mad because you look better. Damn. That's what I'm saying. Come on. This is a very controversial subject, so I don't even want to get into it. For those of y'all who think I'm racist and that I shouldn't wear braids, I can go ahead and just get off my live. Because honestly, like, it's Black culture. According to who? So just because something is another culture, I can't do it? That makes no sense. It makes no sense. If anything, I'm not even going to get into it. If I was racist, I'm not even going to get into it. Because people are still going to hate. It's a free world. That's what I'm literally like. I'm like sitting here trying to correct y'all, but at the end of the day, ain't nobody or their mom's going to come over here and take my braids off. And ain't nobody going to say that to my face. I would love to see someone try.
Y'all hear her? Did y'all hear her say Black women are just mad because she looks better? This is how these throwbacks really feel. Once they copy and mimic your hairstyles and your style of makeup, she got the lashes on, she got the eyebrows emulating the phenotype of Black women. How we look, how we wear our hair, how we dress. And she honestly thinks that she looks better. This is really what she thinks. With that pasty, pale, ashen skin, she looking casket ready. And them dark chocolate lips, she thinks she look good, y'all. She thinks she look better in the styles that you all created. I'm telling y'all, and this is what happens. This is what happens with the pedestalization and the white worshiping and, pedestalizing anything non-Black within Blackistan. These women will be pariahs in their own community, clearly rejects. Their own community be like, ew, you trashy. You are a lowlife. You're poor. You are classless. We don't want anything to do with you. So Maria and Vakisha, in response, go where they want it. And they meander their unwanted asses to the white community that worships anything non-Black, regardless of how basic they are. And then they'll go and throw on some box braids and a Black scent, and they're pedestalized. So they start feeling themselves. And this is how they really feel. This is why Black women need to gatekeep. Stop co-signing this mess. Stop embracing anything non-Black. Y'all be so quick to invite people to the cookout just because they can do a line dance. I saw this girl do the Tamia line dance, this white woman. Black people been doing that ish for years. Black women have been killing it on TikTok with the dance routines. A lot of these routines we make up. But then a white woman will recreate it and copy it and mimic it. All of a sudden, that woman, you know, she's catapulted and has millions of followers and has garnered all these brand deals and all of this clout and fame. And it's only because y'all guys co-signed and enabled this ish. Black women need to gatekeep. Stop embracing these women. Make your support, make your engagement be expensive. Because eventually what happens is that anti-Black woman sentiment is ultimately revealed in this manner. Class is in session every weekend with Sunday School with Lex. Connect with like-minded Black women every Sunday at 6 on the Lex's Exodus platform, where we have live panels and call-in shows in order to connect and share our stories. Discuss divestment and other important topics pertaining to the plights of Black women. Discuss self-empowerment and self-improvement. And much, much more. Tune in every Sunday at 6 p.m. ET at patreon.com/LexisExodus. See you soon. Okay, let's talk about this next Vakisha throwback, who is also trolling Black women, trying to get clout off of us after sporting Black hairstyles and blackfishing as a Black woman.
on the truck. How you got everybody lit piping up? Oh, she bad with no swag, I can type her up. And my last on my last, I know I come up. Count the money up, feel like I'm typing something. I'm the type to get active and never run. Hit the rules, my niggas, I scatter them. Ain't no rules, you got rats, you can get it done. On a light day, I keep me 100 bucks. Making it after he call me very fun. For the Christmas, I bought everybody guns. Lost in choppers and infants for everyone. Take the roof off the car, let up for the sun. I broke up, see his mom, my 5,000 money.
So this is a Spekisha getting box braids, and I guess she experienced some backlash from Black women saying she was culturally appropriating, and this is her response. Child.
To everyone that's just so pressed because I have braids and I'm a white girl, I have one question for y'all. Do you believe that cultures should be shared? And if the answer is no, why do you believe in segregation?
I just wanted to come on here and sincerely apologize to everyone who was offended by me having braids. I didn't think anyone would really care, but I've decided to cut them out because I think it's really disrespectful. Shut the fuck up! That's what y'all really wanted me to say, huh? That's how y'all want me to react to this. Look at him. Kiss my white fucking ass.
She goes on to continue to troll by posting videos of her in a bonnet, calling Black women jealous, and also making a struggle rap music video about quote-unquote hoes being jealous of her.
I'm a bitch, I'm a boss. I'm a bitch and a boss and I shine like boss. I'm a bitch, I'm a boss. I'm a bitch and a boss and I shine like boss. I'm a bitch, I'm a boss. I'm a bitch and a boss and I shine like boss. I'm a
I ain't gotta be no pick me, man. I'm known for getting chose. I can't team up with you bitches, man, cause y'all known for getting hoes. And I send shots, I'm solo dolo, cause I'm known for being bold. Yeah, I got every right to be, cause ain't no niggas pressing me. And I was stop stealing y'all niggas, but ain't no bitch checking.
Why you throwing rocks, got your hands up? Since you an independent woman, you better man up. Three bad with me, I could get your man touch. Ho, I could get your man.
Assume just because you're white, you're ignorant.
Because what were they saying to you when they said you don't, like, you're ignorant of? What were they saying you were ignorant of?
Saying how slaves used to hide food in the cornrows, and that's how, and you know, they would make maps in the cornrows, and that's the significance of it. So it's not just hair, you know, it's something more. And I get it, I understand that, but don't assume that I'm ignorant and I don't know that just because I have braids. They said it's okay if I'm educated, but when I am educated, they assume that I'm not, and it's still a problem.
Well, that's stupid. My daughter doesn't know that. I didn't know this. Yeah. And what the fuck does that have to do with anything? That's like saying you can't wear bell bottoms because they used to wear them for this and you can't wear them for that now. Like, you think about how stupid that is. Do you realize that people are making excuses just to be upset?
I know. Oh, yeah, I know.
Okay, so y'all see this Kay Karen, this Bekisha throwback trolling and being disrespectful. She even goes on Tommy Sotomayor's show for an interview. Well, she eventually gets confronted by a prominent Black woman TikToker named Crystal. And y'all may already be familiar with her. I have featured Crystal on my show previously because I agree with a lot of her commentary. And this throwback just admits that she's just doing this trolling for clout and to gain followers.
Yeah, it's another one of my homegirl, Crystal. She me and Crystal go back years. I mean, she's black. She go back years, and she's strong in the Black community and everything like that. And she had to come to me and say, like, she had to ask, you know, explain to her what's going on. But there's some videos that I didn't even see about because there's so many videos going on with Starlet that, you know what, some of the stuff, I mean, you know, I got your back and everything, but some of the stuff he's saying is kind of like a little bit.
It's not kind of, it's extremely racist.
Yes.
It's extremely racist and offensive.
So
okay, well, I'm not sure what videos that you're talking about, but I am working with a professional marketer who's telling me that this is what I need to do right now, so some of the things aren't what I actually feel and believe, but...
And I quote, I am working with a professional marketer. Some of the things that I say aren't exactly what I feel. She's being told to do it for marketing purposes.
You have a marketer telling you to do that?
Actually, yes, I do. I sent all my...
Child, and if that wasn't enough, she doubles down even after getting dragged by Crystal and challenges Crystal to a boxing match. And fast forward to present day now, she's even looking like Elvira, wearing a helmet head, lace front, continuing to troll Black women.
Crystal, I'm officially calling you out to come fight me in the ring. Since you want to fake phone calls and threaten me and act hard on the internet, I'm calling your hands out.
Crystal the coward, I thought you wanted to fight me on the phone. Why'd you switch it up? If you can whoop my ass, what are you afraid of? I'm out here in Houston at 4 Four Corners Boxing Gym. I'm going to be here Friday, August 25th at 9 p.m. You want to get your beat by a white girl?
What's up, y'all? It's Starla, and today I'm going to be installing my $400 Party City Weave Wig. I was about halfway done, and then I figured I would film for you guys so you can see how a real professional does it. First, you want to make sure that thing is nice and oiled down, and then you can go ahead and customize the size of your forehead. Then, of course, I had my one-year-old do my edges off camera since I don't know how to do them. As long as your face card is valid, it can do most of the heavy lifting. Mwah. Show off the grill a little bit. I love you.
I've been waiting to shoot this nigga for so long. Get a little...
Child, this flatback, pale whale, bleach blonde troll, this dust roach, this cave Karen, this bargain bin Becky, trolling. Black woman, you cannot be serious. This is just a throwback, y'all. And I'm going to need for Black woman to stop letting these basic Beckys get under our skin. Let her thin-haired ass have all the traction, alopecia, and thin edges that she wants. Her hair is too limp and thin to be getting box braids and to be having glued-on frontals and lace wigs. Again, this is a throwback, y'all. This is simply a woman who was dejected, a reject in her own community. She can't be the belle of the ball within her own community. They know she basic. They know she's a barnyard Becky. So hear her bottom feeder ass go coming over to the white community that is white worshiping and very easily impressed by anything quote unquote black that comes in a non-black package. She knows how easy it is to be co-signed by white people by simply mimicking the style of dress, the aesthetic, the colloquialisms, the behaviors and hairstyles of a black woman. So she does this for clout. And even eventually admits when she's confronted that this is what she's doing. She's intentionally doing this because she was told to blackfish because it's controversial and she will gain more notoriety and have a bigger platform after doing so. Sound familiar? Come here, catch me outside, girl, who now is a multimillionaire off of her black scent and her antics. Come here, Will Vicky. Come here, period, I, period, I, period, I. Remember that? Come here, Iggy Azalea and the Kardashians. Remember, Black China came out and said Tyga straight up told Kylie Jenner to mimic a black woman to be put on. Now she's a billionaire. This is what these throwbacks do. They cannot become established and successful and uplifted and pedestalized in their own community. They are social pariahs. They are undesirable within their own community. So they bring their bottom feeder asses to the black community where they'll be worshipped even though they are basic as that. And then they'll turn around and ish on black women like this barnyard Becky is doing. Like this cave Karen is doing. Child, so let's get into this last example of a throwback, this wetback throwback. Erica Mena calling a black woman, Jamaican artist Spice, a monkey and getting fired from Love and Hip Hop after doing so.
You blew my.
Eric, I cannot believe you. You just called this girl a
monkey. Get in the car.
Yo, I hate everybody in this. Gonna let me out.
We hearing that she wish I died on the table and giving me all these racial slurs. Now that the real Erica is out, it just proved to me that Safari wasn't even lying in the first place.
And I bet you she got that from Safari. I bet you.
Man, I don't believe this.
Child, I can't. Y'all still watching Love & Hip Hop, y'all? Seriously, in the chat, type one if you still watch Love & Hip Hop. Any of the iterations, Love & Hip Hop, New York, Atlanta, Miami. I believe this is Atlanta. I stopped watching that ish eons ago. And it's because of stuff like this. That ish is trash TV. You might as well be watching Jerry Springer. I aged out of this nonsense in my early 20s. As a matter of fact, I was looking at the comments and the young folks said Love and Hip Hop is the geriatric version of Batty South from the Zeus Network. I can't. I'm so far removed from this mess. For a good 3 days, I was on here confusing Erica Mena, her throwback ass, with Drea from Basketball Wives, y'all. I was like, oh, okay, so Spice called her a bad mom because she had a throwback who left her son home alone for days with only Lunchables to eat while she went off stripping. And when I tell y'all, I was searching. I was trying to find information to prepare for this show. So I was searching for the Twitter threads and the news headlines for hours trying to find the receipts of Erica Mena leaving her son home for days and getting child neglect charges, thinking of Drea the whole time. Not Erica Mena. Couldn't find nothing. Then it dawned on me. I was like, oh, I'm getting my throwbacks confused. That's the other throwback. They all do the same thing, though. That's why, like, remember Evelyn Lozada got mad at OG, a dark-skinned African Black woman, I believe she is. She's darker-skinned, 4C-having Black woman, because her ex, Ocho Cinco, was in her DMs. So she turned around and called her a monkey as well. So these throwbacks are all the same. It's hard to differentiate them amongst one another. They're all dejected. They're all rejected, all bitter, all unwanted in their own community. So they come to the Black community like this, where they are pedestalized, expecting to get preferential treatment, then lash out at Black women when they receive the same experience as Black women. Like my homegirl Philosophy and Letter said in the private group the other day, this is just buyer's remorse. And when they get pumped and dumped and discarded by Dusties, remember Erica Mena has been made a baby mama three times over, most recently by a Jamaican man, Safari's bum ass. Then Black women become they punching bag. They take all the anger out on Black women. And now this throwback bitch, Erica Mena, is hurling racial epithets at Spice, calling her a monkey. And I'll say the response from Black women to this was interesting to say the least. I saw Black women divided over Erica Mena's comments. Child, this is beyond me. Many were upset, understandably so. You can't be a non-Black woman calling Black women monkeys. You can't be making monkey noises at Black women. Let's be real, y'all. Let's not be disingenuous here. When have you ever heard of a white girl or an Asian woman being called a monkey? It doesn't happen. I remember explicitly people saying Michelle Obama looks like a monkey. I remember people comparing Serena Williams to a monkey. I've never heard of any other groups of women being called monkeys. So yeah, this was an anti-Black woman comment, and this was a racist epithet. And a lot of people are saying this is colorist, but I'll take it a step further and we'll say this is racist. But here's the thing. Y'all have embraced these Hispanic and non-Black women for so long and allowed them to say the N-word for so long. Y'all forgot they're not even Black, y'all. To the point that some Black women are supporting this ish and making excuses, saying Spice was wrong and deserved this abuse for bringing up her child. And my response to that is that's absolute nonsense. This is bullish. It's ridiculous. This is simply disgruntled throwback behavior. Okay? It's disgruntled throwback behavior. Erica Mena came into this community where surface level, she was pedestalized and fetishized. And so she fell for the okie doke, hook, line, and sinker, and thought she was going to have a different experience. And then egg on her face, got a harsh reality check when she received and experienced the same experiences that Black woman. You got pumped and up just like everybody else. What did Spice say? Oh, you're not the only single mother. Join the club. And so now Erica Mena is bitter and angry because this is not supposed to be her life. She's a preference. She's supposed to receive preferential treatment. And so now she's lashing out at Black women, calling us monkeys and ish. See, and my thing is, the scrutiny that Erica is experiencing simply comes with the territory as a public figure. You do bullish as a celebrity and a public figure, you're going to be held under a microscope and you're going to be critiqued. That might sound harsh, but it is what it is. You know, and I have a very small YouTube channel, but even I understand if it turned out that I was neglecting my child, I would get dragged online. That's what comes with the territory. And I love my child so much and take parenting very seriously. So I get that that was triggering to Erica, but you don't get to make colorist, racist remarks just because your feelings are hurt. Especially when you built your platform off the backs of Black women. Because white women ain't watching Love and Hip Hop. Hispanic women ain't watching primarily. They're watching telenovela. They ain't watching your trash ad, your reject dejected ad on TV on Love and Hip Hop. They never did. Erica Mena is who she is today because of Black women. Black women specifically embraced her and allowed her to ingratiate into our culture. Black women allowed her to mimic the aesthetic of us, talk like us, walk like us, dress like us, get plastic surgery to look like us. We've allowed her to come on our television shows with primarily, predominantly Black women cast and pretend to be us. A picture even came out recently that I'll insert here of her looking unrecognizable because she was blackfishing so much and went so heavy with the spray tan. And here she is, fast forward to today, ishing on Black women after building her platform off the backs of Black women. And listen, Black women, y'all not going to like this, but we can't cry foul after being so eager to embrace all these throwbacks into our spaces. I know that's frustrating, but Black women have nobody to blame but ourselves. You know, a lot of us believe imitation is the biggest form of flattery, so we don't gatekeep it all. We embrace and uplift non-Black women who culturally appropriate and copy us. And then when this anti-Black sentiment comes out and this happens, we act surprised. But y'all have to understand the dynamics of this. These white women, these Hispanic women, these Asian women who try to ingratiate themselves into our culture are their own community's rejects. They are throwbacks. But they know the Black community is self-hating and Black loathing and will pedestalize anything non-Black, even if these women are basic as F. Even if they ran through, even if they baby mamas three times over, like Erica Mena. They know that you guys will support and uplift them and pedestalize them. So they come to the Black community where they're embraced without a second thought. And because Black women don't gatekeep, y'all allow them to copy your swag, your style, your aesthetic. They become uber successful and millionaires, sometimes billionaires, off the Black woman aesthetic. They strip you of your resources. Then when you do one thing that they don't like, they tell you how they really feel and turn around and call your Black ass a monkey. Child, make your support expensive. Make your outrage expensive. Gatekeep. Don't let these women come into your space and profit off of your engagement. Don't be allowing these throwbacks who have been rejected from their own communities to capitalize and make millions off of your support and off of your resources and off of allowing them into your spaces. So do y'all think Erica was being racist or was Spice at fault for simply attacking below the belt and questioning Erica's parenting skills? What actionable items should Black women be doing on a daily basis to better gatekeep our spaces from throwbacks like this? Please chime in down below. I'm really curious and interested to hear your thoughts. Until next time, see you guys. Bye.
If y'all come across a red iPhone, if you can please bring it to the soundstage. Red iPhone, appreciate it.